you all for coming today. We have the lovely Adele Creasey, who came back to play music for us. So thank you, Adele. She definitely has just been praying that God just touches all of you through the music that he's laid on her heart, same as me. Our session today is definitely more of a quiet session, finding stillness. I like to call that holy hush, but it has definite benefits. So any type of exercise stresses the tissues of our body, except when we do this style of yoga, it stresses, but it also rests our tissues. So obviously the very end, we lay in Shavasana in our final resting pose to rest our muscles and our tissues after we do some deep, intense stretching. Today's style of yoga definitely targets the deep connective tissues. So our joints, the ligaments, things past the surface fascia and the muscles. As soon as we start to exercise and warm up the muscles, they will normally take the stretch more than the deep connective tissues. So today we get to just love on our bodies with our super deep, deep, deep tissues, which requires us to sit in these poses for a longer period of time. I love that when you stretch the deep tissues of the body, the connective tissues, you have to sit in these poses and quiet the mind, quiet the body, find patience. Just like when we meditate on God's word. So he asks us to not just read his scripture, but to soak it in quietness, and think over his words. And that takes time as well. So I love the connection between how this type of yoga and then the aspect of meditating on his word connect. So I am so excited that you guys get to experience that today. Your body is beautifully created. It's very important, though, that you understand your body in these poses. So as we stretch, even if it's a simple, you would think, oh, well, this is such a simple pose, but we're going to be sitting here for a while. So I don't want you to try to touch your nose to the ground because you can. I want you to find your edge and then back off slightly. And then the connection with the body is I'll let you know about halfway when we're through. I'll prompt you on breathing. I'll be talking to you a little bit and reading scripture over you. Your body may allow you to sink just a little bit deeper. And so inhaling, exhale a little bit deeper. If you're experiencing pain, back off. So just understanding your body as you're in these stretches. We do not use our body to get into the pose, but rather the pose to get into the body. So I want you guys just to enjoy this safe place on your mat. Come to your mat this morning to find rest from the chaos, from the fears, rest from the joys or the losses, resting in our Heavenly Father's truths and meditating on his very words of truth and comfort. So today, I would like you to start on your belly. And so if you need a blanket or anything, let me know. We will be on our knees a little bit. But resting on your belly, you can rest on your arms. You can place the blanket underneath your hips. And then starting to breathe. Inhaling and exhaling, finding the natural breath. Inhaling through the nose, exhaling through the nose. Notice the belly as it fills with air, how it pushes into the mat. Scan the body. Feel the weight of the body on the mat. The earth beneath holding yourself up. Taking some deeper inhales, filling the lungs, allowing the belly to expand, and then exhaling all of the air. The style of yoga today is what I call holy hush. This quiet is a spacious place where you exhale only to realize you had been holding your breath. It is a peaceful place where the frenzy falls away. It is a holy place where you take notice of God's presence You draw near and you rest in him. Be still and know that I am God, he whispers. And you respond with a hushed yes. We know and have been taught that during such quiet moments, we are most open to hear the still, small voice of God speak a personal word of hope and blessing to us in our heightened listening. May the peace which passes all understanding, which has its source within the very nature of the Father, Son, and Spirit, be with us as we meet. Still our souls, join our hearts with yours. May the gentle whisper of the God of peace speak to us through our worship and the movement of our bodies, and through the hearing and meditation on your words through scripture, letting it be the message of our lives. Amen. So gently lifting the upper body onto your forearms, placing the forearms near your rib cage, shoulders near rib cage, shoulder width apart. You can take your hands, placing them thumb to thumb, fingers spread nice and wide on the mat, coming into Sphinx pose. So in our Sphinx pose, allowing the hips to sink into the mat, the head stays neutral with the spine, gently stretching the lower back, continuing to breathe, inhaling, exhaling, relaxing the hips, the lower body into the mat. I will meditate on your precepts and fix my eyes on your ways. Psalms 119:15. Scanning the body, noticing how your body feels in this pose, and remembering to keep breathing. Taking a deep breath, exhaling as we're halfway into the pose, noticing if you're holding any stress anywhere along the hips, maybe taking the shoulders away from the ears. Sphinx pose tones the spine. It's a deep compression and stimulation of sacral lumbar spine, and it stretches the stomach. Sometimes it's amazing to hear how God created our bodies and what movements we do, how it affects our body. So taking the hands and gently lifting the body off of the mat, you're gonna rock back slowly into your child's pose. Knees can be together or on the edges of your mat. As you reach the arms out above, resting the forehead on the mat, you can use a block as well. You can place a blanket on the back of your legs if it's difficult to get down into child's pose. Child's Child's pose gently stretches the spine. It's a gentle compression of the stomach and the chest, and it benefits the organs of digestion and is a soothing pose. So finding that you're able to relax on your mat, focus on the breath, hearing the inhale and exhale of your natural breath. Follow the breath with your mind as it fills and expands the lungs and moves into the belly, to exhaling all the air from the belly and then the lungs. Taking a deep breath, inhaling, exhaling, resting into it further. Always option to take and lift up on the fingertips, pulling the shoulders a little bit forward, really stretching through the upper back, working to quiet the mind and being still before the Lord, letting the distractions, the hurts, the frustrations that you came in with, letting them go. Spending a moment releasing to God what you walked into this room carrying. Gently lifting the hips from the heels, coming into melting heart. It's basically a child's pose with the hips up in the air. So walking the hands forward on your mat, bringing the chest and the forehead down to the mat as the hips lift up towards the air. You can have the side of your face on the mat if that's more comfortable, or really open up the neck, bringing the chin onto the mat. Draw near to God and He will draw near to you, James 4:8. Breath, noticing if the chest can sink any lower towards the mat. Inhaling and exhaling. Thank you. Then from your melting heart pose, walking the hands underneath your shoulders, coming onto your knees and your hands, tucking your toes, gently lifting into a downward dog. Taking a moment to root the heels one at a time into the mat slowly. The movements that we do as we stretch our deep connective is done in a slow manner. Inhaling big inhales, big exhales. Allowing the head to drop. Heel toe or walk the feet out to the edge of the mat. And then take the right hand towards the left ankle, maybe looking under the left armpit up towards the ceiling into a twist. And then releasing the right hand to the mat, left hand to right ankle, looking under the right armpit. Taking the left hand back down to the mat, you can bring the feet back together into your downward dog stance. Taking a couple of deep breaths, inhaling and exhaling. And then gently lowering to the knees, leaning back, we're gonna come into a toe squat. So we're gonna tuck the toes, and we're gonna sit our backside down on our heels. Hands can come to prayer for a moment. Let's do cactus arms. So let's inhale, arms overhead. Exhale as the right arm comes under the left. And as you wrap the arms around each other, it can be palm to palm or the back of the hand to the back of the hand. Bringing the shoulder and the arms out into a straight line, working on stretching the shoulders. And breathing. We were made to meditate. God's designed us with the capacity to pause and to ponder. He means for us not to just hear him, not only to read quickly over what he says, but to reflect on what he says. And knead it into our hearts. If your toes get tired, you're always welcome to drop down onto your heels with the back of your feet flat. You can always readdress tucking the toes. A little bit longer on this hold. Really work on stretching the shoulders. Inhaling, arms overhead. You can kind of shake the hands. Exhale as you bring the left arm under the right. Crossing into your eagle arms on the opposite side. Long straight spine. May the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be pleasing to you, O Lord, my rock and my redeemer. Psalms 19:14. Big inhale and exhale just a little bit longer. Arms. You can tuck the toes and lift into a gentle downward dog. staying there for a couple of breaths, and then coming back down to your knees, rooting the heels into the mat if that's what you need. Coming onto your knees into tabletop pose. Let's just take the ankles and let's rotate them in circles in one direction. And then you can do them in the opposite direction. Beautiful. Placing the hands underneath the shoulders, coming into your cat-cow. So inhaling as we drop the hips, looking up towards the ceiling. Exhaling as you roll the spine, tucking the chin into the chest. So with big movements, pushing away from the mat, and then allowing the chest and the hips to fall towards the mat. Really exaggerate your cat-cows with your big breaths. Into a neutral spine, tucking the toes, lifting into your downward dog again, noticing each time how do the quadriceps, the hamstrings, how does the lower back feel? Scanning the body. Noticing if you can get just a little bit deeper. Stepping the right foot to the front of the mat, dropping the left knee. This is called dragon pose when we are in our holy hush yoga. So in dragon pose, we're gonna keep our hands on the mat. You're welcome to use a block for a little bit of height, but allowing the body, the left hip, to sink in towards the mat. Depending where you have the front leg, in dragon pose, you can actually take the knee in front of the ankle, which stretches the ankle. So finding what's comfortable for you, placing a blanket under the left knee, if this is hard on your knee. Taking a deep breath, exhaling, huge hip flexor, opener, and hip opener. So knee is in direct alignment with the toes of your front foot. We have different pieces of this dragon pose that we're going to work through. It's a sequence. So start by allowing the left hip to sink into the mat. Taking the hands off of the mat, reaching arms overhead in a big breath, and then cactus arms or hands to prayer. This is a little bit deeper into the stretch. Now we're using muscles, but we're also still stretching out the hip flexors. Deep breath. See if you can sink just a touch further into it. Placing the hands back down on the mat, placing the weight on your left hand, is you take the right hand and you open up the right knee, turning towards the right shoulder. So a slight twist as we roll the foot on the outside of the foot. Seconds. Inhaling, exhaling as you bring the right hand on the inside of the right foot, heel toe that right foot out to the edge of your mat, and then allow the body, the left hip to sink in towards the mat as you allow the right knee to fall open into what you might know as lizard pose, or this is called winged dragon. You're welcome to come down to your forearms, placing a block under your forearms for a little bit of height. Deep breaths on the inhale, lengthening the spine, the exhale, seeing if you can sink just a little bit deeper. Always take note of your body if you need to come and back out just a little bit. And then for the final part of dragon, tucking the left toes and lifting the knee off of the mat, your option. This is called fire breathing dragon. So same pose, but you're activating the back leg. Left knee to the mat, bringing the right foot back, coming to the right knee, and then tucking your toes, gently lifting into your downward dog. You can wiggle the hips side to side, bending the knees right and left. And then stepping the left foot towards the front of your mat, dropping the right knee, coming into dragon on the left-hand side. As we start, keeping the knee in alignment with the front toes, and just start by gently allowing the right hip to sink in towards the mat. Always option to use blocks for a little bit of height. Meditation, it is a distinctly human trait to stop and consider, to chew on something with the teeth of our minds and heart, to roll some reality around in our thoughts, and to press it deeply into our feelings, to look from different angles and seek to get a better sense of its significance. Instead, you thrill to God's word. You chew on scripture day and night. You're a tree replanted in Eden, bearing fresh fruit every month, never dropping a leaf, always in blossom. Psalms 1, 2 through 3. So lifting the hands from the mat, bringing arms into cactus, into prayer, finding what works for you today. Seeing if you can come deeper onto the right side, coming forward. Hearing the breath is such focus. The breath is the connection from the mind to the body as you focus on being in this space with the Lord. Placing the hands down on the mat. The right hand is stable. The left hand is going to press into the left knee as you turn the shoulders towards the left, rolling onto the side of the foot. Placing the left hand on the inside of the left foot as you heel toe the left foot out to the edge of your mat. And then allowing the left knee to fall open as you allow the right hip to sink in towards the mat. Coming into your winged dragon, inhaling and exhaling. The dragon poses are deep hip and groin openers that get right into the joint. So it's so good for us, but we have to be careful how we stretch our joints. It stretches the back legs, the hip flexor, and the quadriceps, and it works deeply into the hip socket. It can actually help with sciatica pain. Using a block, you can come down to your forearms. Big inhale and exhale, scanning the body. Tucking the right toes, lifting the right knee off of the mat if you'd like to come into fire breathing dragon. Left knee stays the same. Activating the muscles in the right leg. Inhaling, exhaling, you can drop the right knee, bringing the left knee back onto the mat, and then gently lifting into your downward dog. Wiggling hips, bending knees. Walking the feet towards the hands. We're going to come into our dangling pose. So unlike a forward fold, we're going to allow the upper body to weigh heavy, bringing the head relaxed down towards the mat, slight bend in the knees. You can bend the knees as much as you'd like. Cross opposite hand over opposite elbow. And just rest in this. Allow the upper body to hang heavy. Be still and know that I am God. Psalms 46:10. So take these scriptures while you're in this pose and just repeat them, or find a word that sits with you and just claim it over yourself. Be still and know that I am God. Taking the feet, heel-toeing the feet out wider, we're going to sit down into our squat pose. So you can bring the hands down to the mat as you also bring the hips down to the mat. It's important that the knees line up with whatever direction that your toes are pointed. You can always use a block for a little bit of extra support, one, two blocks, depending on how you stack. Bringing the elbows inside the knees if you can, trying to create a long spine, so sitting up nice and tall. Continuing to breathe. For the Spirit of God has made me, and the breath of the Almighty gives me life. Job 33:4. Placing the hands on the mat, you can lift the hips back up towards the ceiling, heel toe the feet back together, about hip width distance apart, coming back into your dangling pose. So the dangling pose is a super gentle stretch for the spine. It loosens the hamstrings and quadriceps. It provides a massage for the abdominal organs, and it slows the heart rate and rejuvenates the spinal nerves. That I get tired in the waiting, God's Spirit is right alongside, helping us along. Romans 8:26. Again, taking a deep breath, inhaling and exhaling. Hear your breath, inhale, exhale, sinking the hips down towards the earth, coming back into your squat pose, finding what works for you, whether you use blocks. Nice, tall, straight spine. Our squat pose opens the hips and strengthens the ankles. It releases the lower back. So be aware of where your knees are in alignment with your toes, making sure they're going in the same direction. Let's do a nice nice shoulder stretch. So let's drop the right shoulder down towards the knee, taking the left arm overhead. You can take the left hand and wrap it around your lower back for a bind if that feels better. Keep it up in the air. And then release. Let's do the opposite side. Left shoulder to left knee, opening up the right arm. Give me your heart and let your eyes observe my ways. Proverbs 23:26. Placing the hands on your mat, you can rock forward onto your knees, coming into a tabletop. And just spend a moment maybe rocking the hips side to side. You can kind of sit into a child's pose and rock out of your child's pose. Our big hip stretches there. And then walking the knees towards the front of your mat, crossing the ankles, coming back into a seated position. We're going to come into half butterfly. So imagine our butterfly pose, but we're going to do half. So bringing the left foot into the center, right foot's out to the side at a comfortable angle for you. And then we're going to inhale, creating a nice tall spine. Exhale as we walk the hands forward, sinking into our half butterfly. Feet, the left, right foot can be flexed. Head's relaxed. You can tuck the chin into the chest, stretching out the back. Again, finding your edge, and then maybe backing off slightly, allowing the body to invite you to come deeper into the pose. Our butterfly pose stretches the back. It targets the ligaments along the back of the spine. I love your instructions. It is my meditation all day long. Psalms 119:47. Taking a deep breath, inhaling and exhaling as we come halfway through this pose, scan the body. Can you release any deeper into the pose? You can take a big inhale, releasing back into the pose, finding stillness as you sit deeper into the pose. So taking the hands and walking the hands back towards the body, lifting the upper body. You can bring the right leg in, taking the left leg out to the side. Again, sitting up nice and tall. Feel the sits bones on the mat before you fold forward. Inhaling, exhaling, walking the hands forward. Maybe noticing how this side compares to the other side. Maybe this side's tighter. So be gentle with your body as you start to come into this pose. Option to rest the head, tucking the chin into the chest. Taking a deep breath, inhaling, exhaling, filling the lungs, straightening the spine, and then maybe resting a little bit deeper into the pose if your body allows. Sitting in stillness, quieting the mind. Love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your mind and all your strength. Mark 12:30. Walking the hands back towards the body, bringing the left foot in to meet the right, coming into full butterfly. So soles of the feet come together. Great place to use blocks if it's uncomfortable to try to allow the legs to rest open. You can use a block to support or a blanket. You also have the option to walk the hands forward, falling a little bit deeper into your full butterfly pose. Again, tucking the chin into the chest. Inhaling and exhaling. For the Christian, meditation means having the Word of God dwell in you richly. Colossians 3:16. It is feeding our minds the words of God and digesting them slowly, savoring the texture, enjoying the juices, cherishing the flavor of such rich fare. Meditation that is truly Christian is guided by the gospel, shaped by the scriptures, reliant upon the Holy Spirit, and exercised in faith. You keep him in perfect peace whose mind is stayed on you because he trusts in you. Isaiah 26:3. Halfway there, take a deep inhale. Exhale as you scan the body, seeing if you can sink in just a little deeper. If you're folded forward, you can bring the arms out in front as you gently roll back onto your back, bringing the knees into your chest, rocking around on the lower back, side to side, hugging the knees into your chest, loving on your lower spine. Taking the arms out to a T, dropping the knees to the right as the gaze goes towards the left. Option, once the knees come down to the floor, You can take the legs out straight if you'd like for a little bit deeper reclining twist. So noticing what your body needs today. You can place a block under the right knee if the knees are not making it down to the mat. Or place a block in between the knees if it's difficult for the left knee to rest on the right knee. Have you not known? Have you not heard? The Lord is the everlasting God, the creator of the ends of the earth. He does not faint or grow weary. His understanding is unreachable. He gives power to the faint, and to him who has no might, he increases strength. Even youth shall faint and be weary, and young men shall fall exhausted. But they who wait for the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not grow weary. They shall walk and not faint. Isaiah 40:28-31. Bringing the knees back to center, hugging the knees once more into the chest. And then dropping the knees to the left as your gaze comes to the opposite side. Again, using your blocks for any kind of modification for you to be able to rest and enjoy this spinal twist. Twisting at the end of practice helps to restore equilibrium in the nervous system and releases tension in the spine. Hugging the knees into the chest one more time. And then gently lowering the legs onto the mat, stretching out so that your whole body's on the mat. You can take the arms overhead, stretching from the fingertips all the way to the toes. Big stretch. Inhaling, filling the lungs, and exhale as you bring the arms down to the sides of your body. Now we rest. So in our final resting pose, scanning the body, relaxing every muscle, working from the toes up through the knees, into the hips, up through the fingers, into the shoulders. Soft eyes, soft jaw, maybe removing the tongue from the roof of the mouth. We take this time, Lord, to rest in you and to be still. Thank you for your truths, for your spirit, Lord, that transforms us, and for your call on our hearts to meditate on your word. We long to know your heart, your desires for us, to feel your guidance in our lives, and to praise you in everything we do. Lord, we commit to you today this time spent on our mats, that we will glorify you with every breath that we take, that our thoughts and meditations will stay perfectly on you. Thank you.